the connection. So in terms of projection, using the generalized metric, you have bar unities or unbar unities according to how you project, and there's some undetermined pieces of the connection, traces pieces. The non-vanishing services, those projected symbols, are these ones, and they all contain undetermined connections. So the generalized Wooden tensor is pretty good, but it contains parts of connections that can't be determined. Nevertheless, when you take sufficient number of traces, you obtain the stellar curvature we found before and the Ricci tensor we found before. There's contracted differential Bianchi identities, but not an uncontracted one. So out of quantum corrections, this subject with the work of Asher Penn a long time ago, we believe that this only symmetry should survive out of quantum corrections, but at this moment it's not been able to start to understand how to do that, and the lack of a differential Bianchi identity is obviously pathetic. But we believe that double field theory is the right formalism to classify all duality in random effective actions, so we hope to come back to this problem. So the last thing I want to discuss in the last few minutes is large gauge transformations, which was result of a paper published last week. Well, you have ordinary coordinate transformation of a gauge field. You transform the gauge field with this infinitesimal transformation gives you the legal relative. So the question was for us, what is the full transformation that would give us the generalized legal relative that you remember as an extra term? So we wanted something on this style, and there was no guarantee something like that would exist. And to our surprise, something works, and I think it works quite well, and would represent the closest thing to diffeomorphisms in the double space. Like, everybody that has worked in double field theory has heard expressions, well, don't say you have double diffeomorphisms, it's not quite right, and this goes some way into clarifying this question. So what we found is that the thing that was just a single partial derivative in double field theory is this thing, it's two of them. Simpler than we thought it could be. Here, the raising and lowering of indices is done at a constant matrix A. Indeed, if you take a small diffeomorphism, you do find that this gives you the right answer. But that's not enough to find this form. There's some consistency conditions. A partial derivative should transform this way, because it has one, and this one should transform this way, because that's what the partial derivative does. And these two things turn out to be the same because of the strong constraint. The constant metric is actually coordinate invariant. That was absolutely necessary and very untrivial. This F thing is in fact an only dimension. And moreover, the usual coordinate transformations and Kalman field transformations are reproduced. Another way of thinking of large gauge transformations is through exponentials of legal rivers. In fact, if you parameterize a coordinate transformation with a parameter psi acting in the exponential like this, you can prove that the usual transformation of a gauge field is that when you take the passive way into the coordinates are done transform, you just exponentiate the legal relative action. This is a good definition of a large gauge transformation, and we could use it for the generalized theory, and we could ask, well, maybe you should have defined this way that that's the large gauge transformation. So you can ask, does this arise from our definition and some different system? And the answer is yes, but not exactly this one, but a slightly different one, in which it's the same to linear order, but a sparse direction of cubic order, and there's a different system that makes exponential of the linear relative equal to our form. So, generalized linear relative, I remind you, from a Lie algebra, this is the Cauchy identity for the generalized linear relative, despite the fact that the bracket, the C bracket, has no, doesn't satisfy the Cauchy identity. But the Cauchy, the Jacobi, it's called the three parameters, is a trivial gauge parameter, so it doesn't matter for the linear relative. So this transformation, if I wait for the move, in which the parameters composed within the C bracket. And as being operated, they're associated, so you really have a group. Nevertheless, the associator of this transformation of parameters is not exactly zero. It differs by a trivial piece, but that's not the field transformation. So if you think of coordinate maps, the first transformation being this one, the second being that, the map, that is the transformation from x to x double part, is not the composition map. The composition map is the Lie derivative. The map that works here works with the C bracket, so you have a somewhat more exotic map is even here. Sigma 1, sigma 2, and the C bracket of the two things. So if you have a third map, actually map from x2 to x3, you can form the map from x to x3 in two ways, and given this extra term over here in the associator, you don't get perfect agreement, and the operations at the level of coordinates don't quite associate. So this is a little topic at the level of coordinates for sure. The generalized coordinate transformation builds a group and acting on fields, but at the level of coordinate maps, don't quite form a group. And perhaps it is related to some recent work, many here as well, discussing the possibility of non-associative coordinate transformation here. So, time to conclude, I think it's seen some hints that there's some nice geometry behind double field theory, and we'll see where that takes us, and we hope that this will find ways to make double field theory a useful language to do with non-geometric quantification, and we'll learn more about how how Riemannian geometry changed the string theory. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So I think we have time just for one question. Mm-hmm. Yes?
Is there a way to obtain such geometry as a beautiful free shape?
Sorry?
Is there a way to obtain such geometry as a beautiful free shape?
Well, in a sense, this is all the limit of string theory. It's by the strong constraint, you're guaranteeing that this